part of being a good researcher, a productive researcher, is knowing how to communicate your research with the world. Research is meaningless if it's not shared. And I think that learning how to communicate your research better is a skill that will benefit us all and benefit the research, the broader academic community at large.
The reality is that you don't really start reviewing papers for journals until you're a physician out in practice. Honestly, that's a skill that is not intuitive, doesn't come easy, and to my knowledge, traditionally has not been taught in medical school.
The Michigan Journal of Medicine is a really exciting new tool that we have as part of our curriculum here, where students can get academic credit for learning how to operate within an academic environment. And what I mean by that is learn how to write papers, learn how to review papers, learn how to critique papers, and learn how to function generally in the system of submitting and then reviewing and what that entire process entails.
One of the most unique learning opportunities from being involved in MJM is the opportunity to critique a manuscript. It's something I'll be expected to do in residency and definitely in my career as an academic physician. And I hope I'll be able to transfer the benefits to my patients as well.
It's our policy right now that we're not going to turn away any papers. We will work with you with as many revisions as we feel it needs to take to make this something worthy of publishing. And so we encourage students who are even in these really formative stages of, I have a poster and I've done the experiment and I don't know what to do, come to us.
As someone who's been deeply involved in research, a lot of research produces results that are not positive results. Experiments don't work, and we're sure that they don't work, but it's not publishable because it's not a positive result. It's not, doesn't have, you know, it's not sexy, it doesn't have the appeal. I think that as a researcher, part of your responsibility is to disseminate results that don't work and to save other people the time that they would waste on those experiments.
The purpose of sharing data and scientific research and pieces of writing with the larger scientific community is to benefit other researchers and other community members at large. There's a few ways of doing this. One is through the actual data itself. Our goal is to make this completely open access so that anyone can learn from the work that's already been put in.
By learning how to do the process yourself, I think you will become a better consumer of research.
And that will hopefully kind of build a system of these collaborative exchanges that allow students to really work and hone their skills that are going to be very valuable for them in their future careers.